As you can see, I always cut it diagonally. For the reason, it's very easy to poke to the sponge, right? But the second reason, there's a tiny hole in the stem that if you cut it diagonally, it becomes more bigger, so it can draw up more water. So that's the second, that's the first reason. The second reason is that so that we can easy to poke to the sponge. So maybe most of us know already what to put in the flower, in the water when you want the flower to long lasting, right? Any have idea? What's the first one? Sugar. Yes. And the other? Maybe soda. Yeah, work with the soda. But the most common one is aspirin, right? Because aspirin, because we always have in our home. Aspirin is the most common one. And the second one, yeah, the glucose could be the sugar. We will just choose one, don't mix with that, okay? Just we can start with aspirin, sugar, any sugar like soda, lime, tea, vodka, maybe. It will be like mojito now, but yes, but we're gonna use one. Yeah, and we could also aspirin, bleach, yeah, the Clorox you could use. And the last one they always tell me that we could also use is the small blue pill. I don't know what's that. Maybe somebody have idea, so yeah. So, yes. Now we have some glucadendron. So, as you can see, I always, every time I use the flower, I remove the leaves. First, yes, then, first things, it's easy to poke out, to put in the sponge. Second, where the bacteria start is from the foliage. So if the foliage is inside the sponge, it will help, I will directly clean bacteria. And like we say, in 2 days and 3 days, it will start the bacteria. So that's why the flower will die easily because of the bacteria. So every arrangement that we have, mostly we buy flowers in the flower shop, right? And then we put it directly in the vases back home. So all the stems that submerge in the water must remove all the foliage, because if you keep the leaves, the foliage, there the bacteria start, and the second day, the third day, the water will become dirty and then the flower will die. So this will be the first thing to do, remove all the foliage. And of course, as what I said, don't mix all those kind of chemicals with the sugar. You could use it every 3 days, change the water every 3 days, and then after every 3 days, those things that fit this one, not fit the vases that after 3 days, you cut it again to refresh the stem, so that because after 3 days or 4 days, sometimes the stem is rotten already. So we need to refresh it so that it can draw up water again. So every 3 days, cut it inch or maybe just a little, just the rotten part, and then change the water and then mix it again with some aspirin or what kind of what available do you have. Okay. So see, this is the phase. As you can see, I stack it from the back of this sponge so that we have more space to add more flowers in front. We have here the seed and we're gonna add some leaves. So, regarding the bleach, bleach is good to use in daisies and flower kind of flowers, because you see daisy sometimes when you bought it from the flower shop in the next day sad, but the flower is still good, only the stem. That's why sometimes you could buy from the flower shop there's a straw so that it helps to make the stem intact, and also sometimes there's a wire. But if you don't have those things, you could use bleach. If you use bleach, it will help to the stem to become more harder. I sometimes really, I don't recommend the cold water. Sometimes because it really used to, but sometimes different kind of flower, sometimes it shut the flowers, the temperature of the water. So some of the flowers, yes, because some of the flowers are from the cold weather. Some of the flowers from tropical one. So if you But I suggest not just regular, not too much cold. But ice is good for watering the orchids. If you have orchids, just add ice every week and let it melt. Because orchids just want mist, don't want submerged with water. So if you have orchids back home, like the Phalaenopsis or Dendro, it's better to put it, don't water it, just ice every week. Okay? So this is Songophilia. That's it. Dracaena, right? Sometimes when you buy Dracaena from the flower shop, if the next day it seems like the daisy, sad as well, the flower one. What you gotta do, get a full cold water, upside down, submerge it, the flower itself to the water. Just leave it like 3 to 4 hours and it will become good again. That's how you refresh the hydrangea, because sometimes the hydrangea also drink water from the petals itself. Not just the other flowers will drink the water from the stem, but hydrangea could drink also the petals. So that's why if the next day it looks very sad, just submerge in the water upside down, and after the 3 to 4 hours you could use it again. But also we could have these things, alum powder. You just mix with water. You could buy alum powder. Did it drink for 1 hour before we're gonna use it in some arrangement. It also helps the flower to become good.
Do we have any questions from you guys?
Something else later on, that if what if we don't have some oasis, okay? Alum powder, A-L-U-M. A-L-U-M, yeah. It's for the hydrangea flower. So we have this lilies. So the problem sometimes with the lily are the pollens, right? That's why my uniform become now yellow, but it was white before. So what you gonna do, while it's not open yet, you need to remove it. Okay? But sometimes if you remove the pollens, it lessens the beauty of the flower. Right? Sometimes we love it. So we keep it. But sometimes you get emergency, it drops to the carpet or clothes. So what you gonna do, never brush it. Because when you brush it, it will penetrate to our clothes and you cannot remove it anymore. So what you gonna do, just get a sticky tape, put it, tap it slowly by slowly, and you could shake it off by the air. Okay? Never directly brush it, because if you brush it, if you have expensive clothes, and then done it. You need to do it, you cannot use it anymore. And also, be careful with using flowers with fragrance, especially the this one, Lilium, this is the ordinary one. It doesn't have fragrance. But the Casablanca, the Stargazer, smells good but too strong. If you have a small room, sometimes it ruins your nose, right? So now, especially if you have small room, if you don't like the fragrance too much, don't use it if you have small room. Say again, if you're using the flowers in dining table, never use the flower with strong fragrance, because it will ruin your taste bud. You will not experience the perfect, you know, the aroma of the food. It will damage because of the fragrance of the flower.
Why do I I see that you're using scissors. When would you use scissors and when would you use a knife?
Yeah. Mostly, we prefer to use knife. For the reason, as what we said, cut it diagonally. So if you're using knife, see, directly diagonally. But if you're using scissors, sometimes we cut it straight, right? But it's fine, actually, cutting scissors. But be sure it's sharp. You know why? Because when you cut it with that sharp one, you pinch the stem, and then the hole that we're talking about, you clog it. So it will not drink good water, enough water for the flower. So that's the reason why we use more knife than scissor. But yeah, it's fine to use scissor, as long as be sure it's sharp one. Okay? So for now, this is what it looks like. So yeah. Now we're gonna add some flowers. So people also ask, if you give a flower, it should be add or even numbers. Do you have anything about that? Add numbers or even numbers? Should be odd numbers, right? Way back before, maybe in traditional way, it's better to give odd numbers than even numbers. For the reason, when you're giving even numbers, those flowers are for the people who passed away. So that's the reason we usually give odd numbers. We don't give even numbers. Because in even numbers also, for them, it will be more giving you. That odd numbers also will give you luck. So if it's a gift, be sure that you give odd numbers, not even numbers. Especially as what I know, especially in the Latin countries, that's the first that start the rules. Like in the Latin countries, when you give even numbers, it's supposed to be for the one who passed away. And also, I'll show you something here. Like, did you see the bird in paradise, right? It's 5 pieces. You see that? 5 pieces. What if I'm gonna remove one? What it looks like? It's gas. Looks dumb. It's good, but the interest, it less the interest, right? But if you add one, gonna make it odd numbers, it's just one, but it makes something. It gives something, just one, you know. So yeah, sometimes also it gives more interest to look for the flowers if you use odd numbers. Yeah. Leaves, we just make it to cover the sponge. We could also make the leaves as the side. As you can see, this one, what I did, I mix some loaf. You see, it's not just putting the leaves because it's just an arrangement. You could also use to create a design for the leaves. So what I did, cut it sharp first. We're gonna fold this part. So this one have loaf, right? And then we could just add it there. The good thing with these leaves, actually, even without water, it stays weak. So this is the very strong leaves that you could use for arrangement. So yeah, sometimes actually this is like done, but sometimes you could add something. What if you have some kind of branches here? I have here. Just add it to create more, because when you're making arrangement, you're just like all flowers and all flowers. So we could add some branches. So we just add some to create some details. So that's why if you're making also arrangement, don't be afraid to use different kind of leaves. Once you're using different kind of leaves, different kind of shape, it will give more details for the arrangement. Because sometimes we all know what is leather fern, right? Those are very common ones. But we have kind different kind of leaves, even the leaves from your backyard. You can use it after your arrangement so that it will just give more data for the arrangement. This is a birch tree. You just kill it, that's why it becomes white.
Do you choose your colors in an arrangement?
I have actually usually I have two guides for flower color. Either you want summer or classy one. If you're gonna say a classy, chic or vintage, use light colors. White, light pink, light yellow. And if you want very festive, use the tropical colors, the bright one, bright orange, bright yellow, red. So it will be very tropical. So you're gonna choose first, bright or light. That's the first one. The third one, you could mix it. When you mix it, be sure you just use 3 or 4 colors, not too much. Because when you put 5 or 6 colors with bright and light, sometimes it become more messy. So you just 3 or 4, but you could use 5, 6, 7 colors as long as they have same film, like bright, all bright colors, 6, 7 flower colors, as long as they're all bright, it will be perfect. Light colors, 10 colors, as long as they're all light, it will be fine. But if you mix the light and bright, just choose like 3 or 4 colors. And also when making some arrangement, let me say, if you have small room or big room, light colors make your room more lighter. Bright colors will make it more narrower. So that's how it goes. See, this is bright colors. It's, when you look at it, it seems like very near to you, right? But if I'm gonna make, I don't have light here, sorry. But if I'm gonna make light colors, it will be look like very far away from you. So even deciding to buy a painting from our wall, also bright colors, you will see, just walk around in the art gallery, you will see bright even near far. If you see bright arrangement, it sounds like very interesting gives it goes to you near to your face. But light colors will be more wider. So yeah. Just add this American style, we mix all the flowers, all the colors. But European style mostly now groupings, group of flowers and group of colors. So yeah, so if we make an arrangement, it could be like mix everything, that will be perfect. It's also, that's the very common one. But mostly now we used to do it like labeling, as like Cabana also is like labeling as well, right? So those are like, when you be careful, when you do labeling, you're supposed to be like, they call it grouping. It could be same color or same flowers. You could do that one. But if you same flowers with same different flowers, but must be the same colors. If you do the grouping, so that because if you're gonna use here different color, same flowers, different color, same flowers, you will not see those level that you did. So it must be same color always, whatever it's, what kind of flower it's fine.